Good morning. Welcome, welcome. I'm going to chalk today. My husband said, I need a gift for a coworker. And I'm like, okay, I'll chalk something. Because he didn't know what to get. So let's just do a quick, any reason to for me to chalk. Because I wasn't planning on chalking until after Christmas this week. But hey, I have a reason to do it. So let's get started. I'm Robin with Odessa Rose Creates. I'm an independent chalkature designer, and I get to create with chalkature. It's a great DIY home decor company that uses reusable silkscreen transfers, and we squeegee over ink or chalk paste depending on the surface that we're going to use. Today we're going to use chalk paste because we are going to create a tag sign. And so we just need to use chalk paste. It's super easy, super fun, and let me show you how it's done. Oh, that was kind of cool. That rhymed. So say hello if you're watching. I would love, love, love to chat with you while I do this. I'm going to be baking cookies today. I made two candies yesterday. I did my coconut almond balls, and then I was going to make these cookies out of cake mixes. You take a lemon and a strawberry cake mix, and you have kind of like a half and half cookie, but the dough was so sticky, I couldn't roll it into balls or anything, so I ended up just blotching it in a 9x12 cake pan, baked it, and then I thought, we'll just eat it like a cake, even though had the consistency of more like a brownie. Anyway, my husband says, well, why don't you make cake balls? Or said something about cake balls. And I went, oh, perfect. So I made cake balls with them. And they turned out really good. So say hi, hi, hi. I'm not seeing any comments. I hope you're not saying something when I'm not seeing it. Sometimes that doesn't always work. So I am taking a chalkature tag. These are available on my chalk site, which is chalkature.com/Odessa Rose. I try to put a link on this live, so hopefully you can see that. But that's where you get the chalkature products that I'm going to be using today. Right there. We're going to use this tag. I already painted it one coat of black. I just kind of wanted a black undercoat. I'm going to actually then put another coat of brush-on strokes of an off-white. Then we're going to use the Joy to the World sheet music on it, and then we're going to decorate some tags to hang off of it. So it's, yeah, I put all my Christmas transfers away on Sunday, and then he tells me this, so I had to dig through a little bit to find some Christmas ones. But I found them, so we're good to go. All right, let's set this down. We'll get to that in just a minute. Hi, 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 everyone. Okay, I don't know if anybody said anything or not, but I haven't seen anything. And, you know, sometimes you got to go back out of Facebook and then come back in before you see anything. So say hi. Someone say hi so I can see if the comments are open. Here we go. There we go. Debbie Olson. Good morning. Good morning. Yay, Susie received her shirt. Great. I'm glad you love it. Great, great, great. All right. What is today? 22nd? I think so. A few more days till Christmas. All right. Let's grab some. I'm going to use raw silk Fusion Mineral Paint, my go-to. And I'm going to brush on some of this kind of in brush strokes. I don't want it solid necessarily. And we're going to do some layers. So our first layer was the chocolate. I got chocolate on the brain. Black. And now we're going to put some white on it. All before we start actually silk screening. And I probably need to pound this. I just have to pound it so I can open it up. Okay. So after I'm done this, I'm going to bake two cookies today. I'm going to bake, I guess a lot of people call them peanut butter blossoms, the peanut butter cookie with the chocolate star, or some people put kisses on them, chocolate kisses. And I have some Andy's Mint, you know, chip things, and I want to make some kind of cookie with a mint chocolate cookie with those. So that's my plan. And then the other thing I want to make is peanut brittle. I'm really not a baker. I don't bake much, like never. And so, except for Christmas time. Mainly because I don't want to eat at all. And I'd rather chalk than bake. So, that's part of the reason. So, has everyone gone out and seen the star? We went out to look at Christmas lights last night in some of the big, fancier neighborhoods. And I believe we did see the star. There's some great photos of it. That's for sure. Okay, I'm gonna let this dry and then put another coat on. Like I said, I just kinda wanna, like that, just brushed on. Susie, I know you're from California. Where are you from, Debbie? Debbie Olson. Making a last minute Christmas gift for my husband's coworker. Everyone got their shopping done. I bought outfits for each of my kids, grandkids, just at Target. And I got second guessing the size I got for my 6-year-old granddaughter. I got her a 6XS, but I know she's going to be going into 7s soon. So I asked her mom, and of course she goes, well, you could get her a 7-8 shirt, and she's wearing 6Xs now, but if it's for spring, you might want to get 7. And I'm like, oh my gosh. I might just go buy the 7s, and then she can try them on, and then we'll take back what doesn't work. That's kind of what I'm thinking. I just bought them Sunday, so hopefully the same pieces are still there in the size 7s. Okay, it's a little better with a little bit more paint on it, a little bit. I did not bring a glass of water with me to put my brush in. With this paint, it's such a good paint that it's, once it dries, it's hard to get off of something. So I'm going to grab some water. Stick my brush in it. Okay. I'm just going to dry this real quick. We'll end up sanding the edges down anyway. So it doesn't really matter that it's perfectly on there, the paint, because I want it kind of old and worn. Okay. So let's dry that. We're going to hang a couple tag, ornament and a tag up here. So we'll work on those as this kind of dries a little bit. And I was going to paint this. Anybody else is going to say hello today? Oh, really, if you saw the rest of my room, you would not say it was organized. So behind me is my husband's office desk, which I do use the computer, like when I'm using my Cricut. But I was trying to convince him to put his desk. We have another bedroom. This is our lower level. Two bedrooms down here. The other bedroom has the guest bed. And then it has a treadmill thing that nobody uses. So I said, let's get rid of the treadmill, put your desk in there, because I also have piles of surfaces, found surfaces, and new surfaces. And then I have piles everywhere of surfaces. So I said, why don't we move your desk in the other bedroom, and then I can get Shelby in here and be more organized and have all of my stuff in one room. So I'm hoping to do that after the holidays. I would really like to be in one room and more organized. We'll see if it happens. I think it will. It'll be a job to, because his desk is an L-shaped desk, and he's got two computers, and it's kind of a mess, but he is the neat freak, so he will probably go for that. Having it all in one room, because he doesn't like my messes everywhere. But what can I say? If you're a crafter like me, you like to see everything. You want everything out, and you're visual, and you like to see it all. So we'll see. That would be like the best Christmas present ever, is to have my own craft room. Hello from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Good day. Good morning, Deborah. I'd rather craft a cookie. Yeah. I'm with you. Yeah. Would rather craft than cook or bake. I'm not bad at it. And usually once I get going on it, I'm fine. I kind of enjoy it a little bit, but I'd much rather be down here. Crafting and creating. I'm just going to put a little bit of paint on this ornament. Then we're going to put some really cool, I don't know if you've ever seen this stuff before. It's called Metallic Luster. It's by Deco Art. This is the champagne color, and it's called a wax metallic finish, and I actually got some the other day in the espresso coffee, which is a really pretty color, but I haven't even opened that yet. Maybe I'll put some of it on here. Okay, I gotta go put this in the water. I left it in the bathroom. Okay. So my plan is to bake the two cookies today, run to Target, see if I can get size 7s for Vivian, because I just think she's going to be 7 in May, and she's pretty much the size of her age, But, you know, should I get the 6X or should I get the 7? And it's a 7-8 is the size. So it's kind of like, I don't know. And they're kind of more of a Valentine. It's not really Valentine. They're all grays and golds and blacks. I got them for all four grandkids. Try to get that color scheme because I want to get a picture of them. But they kind of have hearts on them. So it's kind of like kind of Valentine's-ish, but not necessarily. And I think it'd be cool to get the picture taken, possibly on Christmas Eve, in their new outfits. If we can be so organized. If I don't know if we can or not. You know, with each kid, it gets a little bit more crazy around here. So, I'm going to open up this Fresa one, but this is what it looks like. It comes in several colors, maybe 6 or 8 colors. But I'm going to rub some of it on. So that's the packaging. I got it at the hobby store. Well, actually, I might order this one online because they never had the coffee one. But the champagne's pretty. This is what I put on. If you remember my piece, it had the Joy to the World music, and it had these three ornaments with the J-O-Y, and that's what I put on the ornaments, was this wax paste. And I just use my finger. I don't know what you're supposed to use, but it just kind of gives it a luster. Can you see that? And I just rub it on. It'll wash off your finger really easily. So just rub it in. I can't think of her name. She's a crafter. Use this. Why is it? Can't think of her name. So, I'm gonna cut this red tag off. And maybe I'll put the brown up on the top. Ooh, it's brand new. In the past, I just used silver metallic chalk paste and brushed on there, but I'm going to use this copper or espresso metallic. Enough. And get it off my fingers, but like I said, it comes off really easily if you just wash it off in the water. Comes off super easy. This is black paint on that hand, but that metallic fusion mineral paint, it's kind of tough to get off your skin. It's water-based, but that's why it's such a good paint. Because it's not like latex where you can kind of just peel it off. It's like, you gotta really scrub it if you don't get it washed off right away. Okay, so you have that, this little tag. I'm thinking about, you know, kind of putting them over here somewhere to the side. But we're going to put Joy to the World on that. And then I thought on this one, I'm going to put joy on this ornament. And I think on this one, this little tag, I'm just going to make a pattern on it just for another dimension to the whole project. This is Holiday Patterns Duo. And I'm kind of thinking of doing this one. And I might do it in just probably the gold shimmer. I really don't want to take this right now, so I'm going to try it. Whoop! I'm going to try it. Chalk over that string. I don't want my transfer sticking to cardboard. Is everyone ready for Christmas? I always think I am, and then, like, I thought about those clothes, and I thought, oh, well, I better go back to Target and get the size 7s. I have more time to return them than my daughter does, so let's just go do it now. Simple pattern in it, and let's put a little wax on these, and then we can chop them. I'm just going to lay this over here so I can get that washed later. Hello, Nancy. I just saw your hello. Share your secrets on my craft. This, I got the big crafting cabinet at house. Everything is at my reach as far as all my pastes and my tools. My Cricut Maker is over here on this cart. But it really is a mess right now. It really is a mess in here, but I'm not very good about, like, it's dusty from sanding down things, and I need to clean. Okay, I'm just putting a little bit of the Minwax finishing wax on here. This paint hasn't had time to cure, so I don't want that sticky transfer picking up the paint. So the wax helps keep that from happening. It makes the transfer not stick so hard. And sometimes on this, even though this is supposed to be a wax of some kind, my transfer can pick it up also, so I'm just going to put a little bit of this wax on top of it, so hopefully my transfer doesn't stick to it. Okay, let's see if that works. Alright, so now I just need to get my black paste out. stick. Give it a swirl. Okay. All right, let's put the little joy on there. Just kind of see how sticky it is. It's not overly sticky. And I'm just going to do the word joy. I'm not going to do the O. I just want the word joy. And black. In the middle. Simple. Set that down there. Okay, so we got our little tags done. Those are pretty. And now we just need to put the sheet music on here. Joy to the world. Kind of sung that. I didn't mean to sing. I'm not a good singer. Everyone's so quiet today. Maybe you're working on some tasks. Oh, here we are. Rosemary, I hear you. I have 5 and I'll try to take a picture of them in Christmas PJs I needed. Good morning. Good morning, Crafty Lady. Good morning, Karen. See, I wasn't seeing all of the comments. I had to go out to Facebook and come back in. So sorry. I was going to make the kids Valentine's shirts, which I still can, but I was going to make them for Christmas. And I saw these really cute ones. Like I said, they're not really Valentine. Well, the girls have hearts on them, but... So I just kind of went with gray, golds, tans, cream color clothes, outfits for like the boys. In fact, Hanks says, I'm not worried about the title. Hanks says something about Big Brother because he is going to be a Big Brother in March. Or it doesn't say Big Brother. It just says Super Brother or something like that. He's a brother. He has an older sister. But he's going to be a big brother in March when the new baby comes. So that's going to be fun. He just turned 4. Yesterday was his birthday. But they've pretty much been celebrating it all month. Because it's, you know, close to Christmas. Alright, I'm trying to get this smoothed out. Just want some of the music on here. The title's not even going to be on because we're going to put these, you know, hanging these off of it. With some ribbons, a little bit of greenery. And this doesn't even have to be chalked to the edge because I don't have the white paint to the edge. So I'm just going to kind of, not make it all the way out to the edge because I really want it to be worn looking. My eyes are just watering like crazy. Hate that. So as you can see, I'm just kind of leaving it almost like brush stroked. All Trying to think if I got more black paste. I need to get me some. I feel like I went through this one really quickly. Okay. That's pretty much how I want it. I'm going to try to skim it down, take all that extra paste off. There. I'm just going to, I'm going to fold it in on itself, and then I'm going to lay it on the paper. Make sure you put sticky side to shiny side, and then I will wash this later. Okay, so there is my music. So I want that to dry. I'm going to sand the edges a little bit. I'm just going to have to do it by hand, and then we'll finish embellishing. Embellishing, distressing, all that fun stuff. Let's see. We'll go back out. Excited to get to watch you live this morning. Thanks, Christy. Although my comments are not coming up. I have to go out of Facebook and come back in. Why does it do that? I'm not sure. I'm going to try going to my page. Alright, let's get this dry. Good morning, Susan. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Just joining, I took a Chocotour door tag. I painted it black, just a light coat. It's getting all dirty from my desk. And then I brushed on some white, and I use Fusion Mineral Paint. It's a totally different type of paint, but any paint will do. But I used Fusion Mineral. And then I chalked Joy to the World, and then I've also made these little tags, and we're going to decorate that up. But I'm going to sand this a little bit. You can really feel the texture of the chalk paste on here, so I might smooth that down also with my sandpaper, and then I'm going to distress the edges a little bit. You could definitely use a little hand sander on the edges, but I'm not going to do that right now. I need some new sandpaper. This is pretty worn out. and even the back edge instead of just the front edge. All the edges. That's probably distressed enough. Let's get this dust picked up. This is why it gets messy in here, because of doing that sanding. I'm even gonna wipe a little bit on here. Alrighty, everybody, let's get started here. I'm also going to plug in my hot glue gun because I may want to actually glue those tag and ornament in place so they don't shift around. Think about that. So I got some fun ribbons. Has anybody picked up the fur ribbon from Hobby Lobby? I love it, I just haven't used it yet. Well, I haven't had it very long. It just looks so cozy. Let me see. It's really nice. I was thinking just a piece of it. I'm just going to mess with it. See if we like it. I think I might cut it down narrow. Let's see what it looks like. I'm just going to mess with it for a bit. This project. Now we have hair everywhere. But I'm thinking if you wanted to cut it down without cutting the fur, if we can cut the back. Like that. I'm gonna get rid of that edge too. I don't like the the binding on the edge. Woo, now we go. Fur everywhere. Good grief. Okay, let's see what else we can do. We got some greenries, some green ribbon, this ribbon. This stuff's cool too. I just took that pin out. And I don't know where to put it. There it is. Oh my gosh. It just shot. The pin just shot off over there. I don't know why. Crazy. I'm just going to gather a bunch of ribbon. I could get longer. I think I need something black. Grab something. You have a one-sided ribbon, and you're making these little tails. You want to take the back one and twist it so it's forward-facing, like that. So it was like this, wrong side, and you just need, wherever you're going to pinch it, you know, twist it right there so it's forward-facing. some black lace. I don't have much of left, so I'm going to take all of that. And then I'm going to put a piece of twine on the back of this bow so I can loop it into the hole of the tag. So that's just going to be for mechanical purposes. But now I'm going to lay this black ribbon, this lacy one, under. I'm going to bring it to the top and tie it all together. Just trying to even it out. So I'm going to tie my shoe. I'm going to loop it. Cinch all this up. Okay. That's cinched. And then I'm just going to tie my shoe with a bow. We got that hanging there. Something like that. Let's turn it all up. I'd rather, okay, make sure there's any new comments. I'm going to dovetail these little ribbons up here. So I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to take in this string that I tied through on the back, and we're going to use that to tie that on there. I'm also going to maybe take this little, I got some burlap ribbon that came off of something we bought. I don't know what it was. Take a chunk of it. And I'm just going to loop it through the hole. Nose is running. I'm gonna go back out. Come back in. The first creeping you out. That's hilarious. Oh gosh. Okay. So now we need to attach the bow to the board. And I think I'm going to just put way I killing me. All right. I need something like, if it was just for me, I would do one thing, but since it's a gift, I want it to look nice and finished on the back. I need like, just a chunk of wire. This will work. Break it. Ooh, that's tough. Wow. That was a good wire. I'm so weak compared to how I used to be. There we go. So I'm going to lay that big wire across there so I can tie this to it. So I got my wire nice and tight. I don't even know if I need this on there, but I'll leave it on there. Okay, so now we need to add this. See the word joy. Another string on this just to make it look like it has a hanger, even though I'm going to glue it in place. So this is just kind of for looks. So I'm going to do something like this. And I like to use a combination of E6000 and hot glue. The hot glue sets it quickly, but the E6000 is a stronger glue. This one's about gone, but I think I can get enough out of it to serve the purpose here. Maybe? Hole in it because it's like getting my fingers all sticky. Now, fur fuzz on me. I'm a mess. Alright. Stick that right there. And then this one. About time for this one here to go in the trash. This tube. Yikes. Put the lid on it. I want it to hang, you know, not straight down, just slightly off the angle, like that. I'm going to stick my string up in here. See if it's hanging off of that. And I might need to glue that in place so it doesn't fall out. Same with the other tag. So we're gonna cut these or leave them on. Alright. What do you think? Sometimes you can tack a little bit of glue right there, maybe. Get it to stay there. Let's see. I'll just keep fiddling with it. I might put just a dab. I'll probably do the same with that one. Kind of push it up a little bit, put it right there. Okay, there. I think it's done. I'm gonna maybe do a little bit of distressed ink on the edge. Then I'll be done. And some. Just to age the edges here a little bit. Some distressed ink. Gotta put the greenery in. Yes. This stuff here will make a huge difference. This will bring some life to it. Absolutely. I'm going to curl these little wires a little bit. It's going to look like vine. Time. And some berries. Okay, I might get a little bit more of this, put a little bit up here, but it's in the other room, so it gives you an idea. Yeah, this ink's about shot. Okay, I think I'm done. Except for I might put a little bit more greenery up here on this top part. But you get the idea. Yay! That's the gift. You see the fur? There it is. Alright, guys. You like it? I'll put a little bit more greenery up here, and I might glue this in place a little bit, a little fur, very wintry, so a fun piece. You know what else I also do, is usually I darken around the ornament edge, I forgot to do before I placed it on here. Glue strings everywhere. Okay. Alright. I'll go grab some more of that and then I'll photograph it and you'll be able to see it on my page. I'll have it done for the gift. Fun. Okay, guys. Thanks for joining me today. Now, really, I'm done chalking till after Christmas. I gotta go bake cookies this afternoon. So... thanks for joining me, and have a Merry Christmas, and I'll see you next week. Yeah, probably. Merry Christmas, thanks for chatting with me, and have a happy holidays. Bye!